So 10th A, our today's lecture is the how to insert background image in the web page, okay, using CSS. So I'll be starting first of all with the internal style, head tag. Here I take the style tag and I am taking text / CSS, right? When you were working in HTML, you used to do this for inserting the image in the background. Body, background equal to, and here is the complete path of the image. Here you supposed to write complete path of the image. Isn't it? But now as we are going through CSS, so the scenario will change. Body. Here body is acting as a selector. You will take background hyphen image colon URL function. Okay, got it? Background hyphen image colon URL function. In the bracket of URL function, you will write the name of the image which you want in the background. Okay. But one thing you have to keep in mind, the image that you want to insert in the background must be in the same folder where you have, where you are going to save your HTML web page. Okay. Suppose you are going to save your HTML web page in documents in ABC folder. There is one folder ABC and that folder is in document section. And you are saving your HTML file in ABC folder. The image file flower1.jpg must also be in the ABC folder. Then only you will be able to insert image in the background. Okay, otherwise this image won't be displayed. Am I clear to everyone up till here? I repeat my point again that you have to save your image in the same folder where you are going to save your web page. Clear? So this is how you can insert image. Now going with the rest of the selectors, I'm going to format here H1. H1 is going to take these properties, font family. I am taking Rockwell. You can take any font family as per your convenience. I'm going to take font size as 60 pixels. Okay. Then other properties which you can place here is text align colon center, text decoration for underline. Okay. Then you can have here font weight bold, right? And font variant small caps. Clear? Now moving to the next category which I'm going to format is your paragraph tag. I'm going to format paragraph tag. Okay. Here I'm going to take font family Arial. I'm going to have font style italic. I'm going to have font size 50 pixels. Okay, then I'm going to have here color of the paragraph as blue. Here heading color I am taking red. Clear? Up till here, am I clear? Any doubts up till here? Okay. Now here I'm going to take one more selector to which I'll be applying the style rules. I'm taking here LI, list item. My all the options in the list must be in green color. My all the options in the list will be in Verdana font. Size of the list will be 40 pixels. All the options must be bold. Okay. Then font family is okay. Font size is okay. Font weight is okay. Okay, that's all I want for the LI. Now here I close the style tag. Here I close the head tag. Okay, and I proceed with the normal HTML coding, that is your HTML code, right? Now, first of all, I am going to put the heading. Heading is subjects. Let the heading be board exam term 2 H1. Here in the paragraph we are progressing towards term 2, which will be in the month of end March. The exams are going to be purely subjective, so everyone needs to work hard. These subjects are, here I close the paragraph tag. Okay, got it? Then here I start with the UL list. And in the UL list, I am taking my first subject as English. I am taking my second subject as Maths. I am taking third subject as Science. I am taking the fourth subject as Social Science. Then I'm going to take here Punjabi. Then I'm going to have here Computer Applications. And here I'm going to have Hindi. Okay. So I close the UL here. And finally, I close the body tag. Finally, I close the HTML tag. Right? So this is the entire coding I have typed in front of you. I give you 1 minute. All of you go through the coding minutely. Right from the top till bottom, all of you go through the coding minutely. And first of all, focus on this command, how to insert image in the background. Earlier, you used to insert color in the background. Now you will learn how to insert image in the background. The image that you will insert via CSS, image will be repeated horizontally and vertically. The image will be repeated both horizontally and vertically. That settings you have to do as per your convenience, right? So this is the rest of the part of the coding. Now I save this coding in documents folder and my image is already there. 10th A image dot HTML. Right? Now I minimize it and I open the documents folder. And this is my web page. I right click on it, open with Google Chrome, and check image is there. I told you the image that you will insert will be repeated horizontally and vertically. Vertically, think on y-axis, horizontally, think on x-axis. See the movement of the mouse on the screen. It is going vertically here. This is repeat in the Y terms. Here it is going horizontally. It is going in the X axis terms. So image is by default repeated both horizontally and vertically. Is the browser view clear to everyone? Everybody can see the browser view class. I'm getting response only from Arpit, Khushi, Arman, Mishti, Devita, Rahul, Prabhgun, Garima, Arshin, Jay, Aditi, Chaplin, Saket, Tarundeep, Ankita, Karanjot is not here, Saharsh is not here. Just their names are visible. Okay. Now see what changes I'm going to do in the coding part. Click here and write background repeat property. Background repeat property. Right? The background repeat property is used to set the repetition of the image either horizontally, either vertically, or either both. It has four possible values. First is repeat X. First is repeat X. Check it out. Image is only repeated horizontally. Niche ki taraf dekho, white area ho gaya sara. Image is only being repeated horizontally along the X axis. Okay. Clear? Repeat Y. Image will be repeated vertically. Check it out. Clear? Then only repeat. Only repeat means the default value, both horizontally and vertically. Clear to all? Horizontally and vertically, both ways image is repeated. Then you have no repeat. Just on the top left corner, image will be displayed. Just on the top left corner, image will be displayed. No repetition horizontally. No repetition vertically. Clear to all? Then one new property I'm going to discuss. The property is background hyphen size. This property is used to set the position of the image, the size of the image. It has three values: auto, cover, contain. Let us first of all go with the auto value. The normal, the default value of background size is auto. Jo background mein no repeat hai, background size mein wohi auto hai. Okay, clear to all? Then is cover. Cover means it will cover the entire screen. See here, the entire screen is covered. This property will help you while making your project. Suppose you want to insert any background image in your project, this property will help you. Okay, clear to all? Then is contain. Oh, sorry. See, the image is appearing complete, but in the partial view of the web page. It is not covering the entire screen. It is just appearing in the vertical shape. It is not covering the entire screen. Right? I go with the cover value. So this was about your background image, how to insert image in the background using CSS. Clear to all? Now, next thing I'm going to do is pay attention on this text decoration. Pay attention to this text decoration, this property. This property is used to underline the text. I guess it is already underlined with the red color. It is already underlined with the red color. Let us see some changes here. I want to underline it with blue color. I want to underline it with blue color. Check it. The color of underline is blue. Have you noticed, all of you? You want to underline in yellow color. After giving underline, you write the color name and that is yellow. The heading is coming in yellow color. Now, you don't want to have straight underline. You want to have underline in some other style. Dotted. Underline, space, the style that is dotted, space, color, whichever color you want for the underline. Check it. You don't want to have dotted underline, you want to have wavy underline. See, it is coming in wavy form. Jaise waves hoti hai na, us tarah se. Another style which you can have is double. You want to double underline. Check it. So all these things will help you in making a good project with better properties, with better formatting part. And apply all these properties in your project because it is final term project. Okay, and it will be going directly to CBSE. So make your final term project a very, very better one. Then instead of underline, you can go overline. Overline means instead the line is coming at the bottom, line will come at the top. Check it out. The line is at the top of the heading. Earlier, when you took underline value, the underline was coming at the bottom of the text. But now the underline is going at the top of the text. Then you can have line through. Check it out. The line is crossing in between the text. The line is crossing in between the text. Have you noticed all these changes which I am doing in the coding? Parallel, you are noting down the browser view. Clear with this? So I again come back to underline part. Okay. Now suppose you want to set your list items, these list items, you want to set them in border. So for that, I am going to format the UL tag. I'm going to apply the border related properties over here. 4 pixels. Border color, I'm taking yellow. And border style, I'm taking rich. Okay. I am increasing the size of the border. I'm taking it 7. Let's see what happens in our coding after doing this change. Check it out. The list items are coming in the border. The list items are coming inside the border. Let us apply background color to it. Let us see what happens when we apply the background color in the, not in the paragraph. I want in the UL. I want here. Background color pink. Check it. Formatting of the web page, how to present the coding, how to make your project presentable is in your hands. Creativity is in your hands. We will appreciate, we will welcome utmost creativity. But don't make your project a hodgepodge. Ki wo bahut over lage. Over bhi na lage, decent, soothing lage. Aur bilkul low level ka bhi na lage. Ki kuch kiya hi nahi hai. Am I clear with all these things? Yes, class. Please give your feedback fast so that I can know how many are attentive in the lecture. I'm scrolling through the vertical bar of the Zoom and I'm looking how many thumbs are up. Saket is not here in the lecture. Karan Jyot again, thumb is not up. Saharsh is not there in the lecture. Prabhu Noor is not here. Dhavnesh Bhagat, Naina, Gur Sevak is not here. Himanshu, thumb is not up. any doubts, any questions, then I proceed with the next concept. Arman has some. Yes, Arman, come on the video first, then unmute yourself. Whosoever wants to ask question, come on the video first. Am I audible to you, Arman? Okay. Yes, Arman, unmute yourself now.
सर जब आपने वो इमेज लगाई थी उसके अंदर हमें प्रॉपर्टीज में जाकर उसका पूरा पाथ नहीं लिखना।
अगर आपकी इमेज उसी फोल्डर में है जिस फोल्डर में आपका वेब पेज है, then there is no need to write the complete path.
ओके सर।
ओके। नाउ इन द सेम कोडिंग आफ्टर दिस आई एम गोइंग टू start or I open the new web page. Okay, our next lecture is hyperlinks in HTML. Right? I start with HTML. Head tag, title, hyperlinks. I close the head tag, I close the body tag, I am taking the background color as silver. Okay, I am going to take attribute link. The color of my link is initially white. Then I am going to take color of a link, which I am going to take blue. Then I am going to take color of the v link, which I am going to take red. Okay, and I'm taking the background color as gray. First of all, pay attention to all these three attributes which I have taken inside the body tag: link, a link, and v link. Hyperlink is very important concept. Okay, so understand it very, very clearly, thoroughly, and carefully. Okay, you have to use in your projects also. Now, link attribute. One thing, link tag you did in external style sheet. आपने जब external style sheet बनाई थी, उस time आपने link tag use किया था. Now we are going to study hyperlinks. Link is working as attribute of body tag. Link means the color of the hyperlink. The initial color of the hyperlink. When your web page will be displayed, what will be the color of your hyperlink? That is known as link. The default color of link is blue. Okay, I have taken white, but please note it down. The default color of link is blue. Then comes a link. A link means active link. Active link means the color of the link which you are currently clicking. When you currently click on the link, for a fraction of second, the color that will appear is the color of the active link. That is A link. V link, visited link. The full form of V link is visited link. Visited link means the link which you have already visited. The link which you have already visited, that is V link. Okay. The default color of link is blue. The default color of A link is red. The default color of V link is purple. All of you, please note it down somewhere in the rough copy. If you having rough copy along with you, the default color of link blue, default color of A link red, and default color of V link is purple. Now, what is hyperlink? Hyperlink is a highlighted word or a highlighted text that enable us to jump from one web page to another web page. You want to connect with one web page. Okay, you are working in one web page and you want to get connected to some other web page. So hyperlinks will help you to do so. In order to create the hyperlinks, we make use of A tag. A tag is known as anchor tag. Right? The anchor tag has first attribute href. href is known as hyperlink reference. The hyperlink reference attribute of anchor tag is used to take the name of the target web page to which you want to jump to. Aapko jis web page pe jump karke jana hai, us web page ka naam href ki attribute ki value ban jata. Okay. Then here you create the hyperlink. Any hyperlink you can create here. This hyperlink, which I have created over here, will be in initially white color. When you will click on it, it will become blue in color. When you have visited it, it will become red in color. And close the anchor tag. What is the meaning of this command? The meaning of this command is clicking on this hyperlink, click here to view. This web page will get open up, page1.html. When you will click on this hyperlink, click here to view, this web page, page1.html, will get open up. Clear? Am I clear to all? Yes, class, am I clear? All right.